The iodine producer Iofina has told investors that total 2016 sales through Iofina Chemical have now surpassed 2015's total, but production is expected to be lower for the second half. I've got with me on the line now President and Chief Executive Dr. Tom Becker. Tom, good to speak to you.
Thanks, you too.
First off, where's the increase in sales come from?
So the increase in sales, all of our sales go through our chemical division, Iofina Chemical, and we've had really nice sales in our iodine derivatives and our non-iodine derivatives. We make some chloro and fluoro-based derivatives as well. But we've also increased the amount of pure iodine that we've sold into the market that we've produced from our individual plants.
And you mentioned your non-iodine products. Those two have also beaten expectations?
Yeah, we have certain expectations every year on those particular products. We've seen a nice growth in demand, especially in the second half of this year, and we anticipate that to be the case moving forward.
Now, you've highlighted second half production will be lower. Just run us through, if you would, why that's the case.
Yeah, there's a couple of reasons. Recently, we've run into some production issues that have caused our production levels to not quite meet our expectations in the second half of the year. We use produced water that's produced from oil and gas, and we get that water from our partners in the field. When they have fracturing jobs in the field, they occasionally divert water. As oil prices have recovered from earlier this year of at or below $40 a barrel, up above $45 to $50 a barrel, they've actually completed some wells that they had previously drilled but not completed now that the oil prices recovered a little bit. So that's affected our supply of brine to our plants recently.
How do you see expectation heading into 2017 for production?
While we've had this bit of a hiccup late this year on our production, 2017 looks good. We anticipate being back to normalized levels in early 2017 and producing iodine from our five iodine plants in the state of Oklahoma.
Iodine prices, of course, have fallen around 20%. What's your outlook there?
Yeah, iodine prices have fallen steadily over the past few years, similar to other commodities. While other commodity prices have recovered, iodine prices, unfortunately, have not recovered yet. We don't anticipate very much of an iodine price change in the near term. The long term, we view iodine prices have the potential to go up. And the one good thing, I guess, that Iofina can claim is that even though iodine prices have come down, as we've noted, our sales have gone up, even in this declining market.
So overall, how would you sum up your performance and your progress? Are you happy?
Pretty happy, especially on the chemical side. Not really happy in the short term of our iodine production, but we see us recovering back to normalized levels here very soon and being on track for 2017.
Really good to speak to you, Tom. Thanks for taking the time.
Appreciate it. Thank you.